Yeah, as I told, it's hard to distinguish operational core and middle managers. And this is illustration. These are teams. So somebody who is from here brought this idea from the market, find somebody from Technostructure, somebody else from Technostructure which really needs in this project. Three, five people from operational core maybe brought some additional contractors to this project, and this project operates. And other project is just the entire operational core. And other project is kind of more comprehensive. It's more on middle managers level. But it's still, the idea is the same. All of them start from idea which goes from our clients. From our clients. This is operating adhocracy, and I love this structure. Administrative adhocracy, it's closer to traditional, and I think it's more applicable to many of your organization. It's also functions project, but who makes this project? Who says that we need this project and we don't need this project? These projects... This project serves the needs of the organization itself. Organization itself, and usually we kind of distinguish pretty clear where administrative level and core level. And administrative level kind of says we need this and that project to be done. It might be new line. It might be new major. Yeah, but this major is not kind of somebody who found two of 100 clients and brought it here. No, it goes from up. And somebody from top management decides that this is a great idea. And again, they have their own simple rules on administrative level. And they believe that this is, would be a good new product. And they use facilities of organization to build this to implement this product. The difference with traditional organizations still, you see, is it looks kind of similar to traditional organization, and it looks like this. But the main idea is that this also operates, this level also operates in projects. Projects. It's not like processes. It's projects. We have this project, somebody from here, this smart guy, brought this idea, kind of sold this idea to inside of this organization, and he or she built this project, and he invited professionals from here, professionals of here, middle manager, etc. Operational core is not important in this organization. It might be just kind of labor approach, or it might be 100% automatization, like in oil. In oil companies, main decision are made here, and here it's everything just automatic. So this is how operate administrative adhocracy, and you see the main idea of both of them, administrative adhocracy or operating adhocracy, is to explore people's initiatives, give them a chance to broaden this idea and to develop this idea to the final product, to the final product. Again, without simple rules, doesn't work. So only combination of this. Okay, we are done with new planning, new organizing, and now we say new employees. New employees, people who are on the market and people who are waiting for our new generation. It's not baby boomers anymore. It's not even the next generation, and it's just new generation of employees. And it doesn't matter. I don't relate to the age, real factual age. I relate this to attitudes of people. Old employees versus new, old personnel versus new personnel. It's more and more free agent on the market. Who don't care about this particular place for 20 years, who feel like I do this now because I built my expertise now, and maybe tomorrow I will continue building my expertise for sure. I'm business for myself, but it might be your organization if I continue, if I'm still learn something here and I gain something here. If it's not, I'm not going to stay here forever. It's more and more people who don't care about tenure and care about their own level of expertise, their own portfolio of talents, skills. And you see, instead of job of life, now gig for now. And they're very much proud to have portfolio of temporary assignments. But these assignments are, first of all, different. They have portfolio. They don't do one job for 20 years because nobody needs these employees. They have portfolio of jobs they're able to do. And they shopping in different companies to gain this expertise. waiting for benefits from this company or benefits travel with you. And again, if you have all this expertise, if you are really good, you can negotiate this these benefits, and you know that you can do this. You don't have to ask your for mercy. Please give me this and these benefits. You know that if I'm worse, I can negotiate this. And this is kind of follow with you. Doesn't matter in which organization. You kind of feel strong to talk about this or to buy these benefits. And career strategy. Do what you told it used to be, and now, and it's still in many organizations. So you see, it's kind of, again, a revolutionary approach. New approach to career strategy, do what you excel at. Continuing, it used to be 9 to 5, kind of my day is done. And I still know many people, especially in the town where I live, which just say, yeah, they honestly say, yeah, I work for this organization. I'm free at 5, and it's so important for me to be free at 5 and focus on my family. Nice, but it's not what new market needs. And the goal of new personnel is, yeah, to make things done. Competence versus mastery. So I'm the best. Not I just am good, I am the best in this, and I know that I'm the best. And I make you know that I'm the best in this field. I like this. Instead of Detroit model, the Hollywood model. Different studios. And if you're good, you may work with this studio or you may work with this studio. It's okay. You are just an actor. But if you are really good, they will compete for you. Not you will just ask and please employ me for forever. And if you're a good writer, again, they will compete for you, not you will ask for long-term employment. Gold, I am my boss right now, so I'm boss for myself and I make my own decision. Horizontal loyalty, you see, instead of vertical loyalty, these people, to be successful, they need loyalty, but it's a different type of loyalty. This loyalty with others in their network. They need loyalty with their other professionals because only together they can do good projects. They need their own network because all together and they can do good projects. And they need loyalty of their customers. But they don't need the loyalty with their boss. Because boss in temporary, clients are forever. So this is kind of different type of loyalty. And the last, yeah, unfortunately, I have to confess that I am an old personnel, and all previous, I feel that it's just exactly about me, new personnel, it's how I feel in this life. But the last, well, unfortunately, I call to tech guys always when I have a problem, but maybe it's time to change. We are supposed to be tech guy because it's part of, it's like writing, it's like reading books. It's so we have to be very professional in our IT stuff. So this is new personnel, and this is people who we need for our company. Because if you talk that our company need talents, they are here in yellow. You see yellow color in my slides. They are not in white color in my slides. In white color. It's just mediocre employees. They're okay, but they don't move our companies to a new level. In yellow, they do.